Shall we look at our homework?
Yeah, let's do it.
This one I didn't fill with stuff. It's a blank space.
Yeah, so I didn't know. Okay, so first, compliments. I thought that your figures were more proportional. And your perspective lines are more cohesive. Although the front door does look like it's about to fall over a little bit, because like the they're not straight up and down. So, yeah. But I didn't understand what was going on in this panel really, because I there's a guy punching a wall. I'm not sure if it's a wall or a door or a vault. There seems to be something ringing on top. There's Mortis, so I know that means like death. So it's like a morgue, and there's a guy with guns.
That guy is clear. That guy got really messy then. He looks like he has guns.
Okay.
He's supposed to be like pointing, like, but he's tiny. Because I always draw my people very small.
Okay. I wasn't sure like what I was supposed to get out of this panel. I noticed that one of our homework assignment, one of the things in the homework assignments is that we're supposed to have the reactions of one or both characters in the facial expressions or bodily gestures. And so I didn't feel like there was as much of a reaction, you know? It was just like, this all is happening, you know?
I was trying to have that gun guy have his little reaction. But again, he was tiny, so it got really muddled.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think I definitely just drew the guy punching and then was like, oh, crap, what do I do now? And I think that maybe, you know, taking a step back and planning would allow someone to, perhaps me, lay things out in the most dramatic, the most efficient way. And I'm definitely going to be thinking about all the perspective and stuff that I loved about yours when I do my homework for Chocolate Food.
Although I did... when I saw this, I actually thought that it reminded me of The Wizard of Oz, like the gates of the Emerald City. Mm-hmm. Is that what it is?
Oh, it's not like the gates of the Emerald City. I was just like, I mean, I've been punching, and then I was like, why is he punching? And I was like, well, maybe he wants to get through a big brick wall. And I was thinking of like, at the start of the Mines of Moria, when they do the word, I was like, well, what if they just punched their way through?
Okay.
And then the rest of it, I was like, now I need someone having a reaction. Okay, now let's look at yours, because it's awesome.
I don't know about that.
It's very exciting for me, as a fan.
Okay, as a fanboy, yeah.
Yeah,
have you noticed how everything that I draw becomes fan art? Everything I draw. Like,
I'm not complaining. Awesome, right? Patriot, jumping down through the roof, crazy cool. Yeah. I didn't offline critique this one yet, so let me whip out the criteria and think about what I'm looking at.
Okay.
So, is the sequence of events in each panel clear? Yes, it's super clear. There's a big crash, and then there's a dude, and the partygoers are like, what is going on? This is the weirdest episode of Queer as Folk I've ever been in. and then follow the path with your finger. Okay, down. but there is. There's a top-down and a left-right movement in the picture, which is really... interesting. It's cool. I mean, because I do think that when you do... So, I saw a movie recently where... it was Thor. Do you remember in Thor, whenever Kenneth Branagh wanted to have anything dramatic, he tilted the camera? And it's like, because you tilt the camera doesn't make things super dramatic. But definitely, if you have someone jumping in through a skylight that's off and the world's kind of askew, I think that does make it pretty It's pretty dramatic. But if you did your whole comic diagonally,
yeah,
it would lose that effect. Just like Thor. So switch it up in the next panel, which we never get to see. But no, I love that. I love that about it. And this is, yeah, and you have your Emanata, your verbal Emanata, the 70s Batman, crash, pow, bam, which I really loved in all of your panels.
I also really like like sound effects that aren't sound effects, like
shadow.
No. Like I mean, I remember like there's I don't know. This happens a lot with more with Japanese stuff, but like you know you'll have someone like pull on like a shirt collar and they'll say pull, or like they'll push or like sit, you know.
Exactly. Well, and that's what I was trying to get at with the shatter, because I mean I guess that can be sort of onomatopoeic since there's a tinkling sound to the word shatter, but like because you had crash, which is generally considered onomatopoeic, but if you had like glass break.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, and there's some good, there's a Scott McCloud book that I read once for a class that, that has a whole panel that's just like, they draw things out of the words. So like, drum is the drum set. I mean, it's got cymbals and stuff on it, but, and then coming out, much like in Scott Pilgrim, how they would have the noise effects and they have the lightning drawn onto the frame. Instead of having lines, instead of having emanata, they would just have the word like noise.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that can be really cool.
It's like so postmodern, and I'm like so cool, and I'm not even trying to be this cool.
Beck does all our music. Okay, what's next? Does the composition need to be adjusted in order to make more sense? No. I think you're pretty good. Are the characters clearly defined? Yeah. How are the images framed? I don't know. It's finely framed. I don't have any ideas. If you guys have some feedback, put it in the comments.
Yeah, I tried to make it menacing with the people in the background, but then I realized that, perspective-wise, they were kind of becoming wonky. But
they do seem pretty big.
Somehow. Yeah.
But I assume they're standing on steps.
Or something. Yeah.
Exactly. I guess that's a good point. They talk about the balance next and the use of the space. And the focus definitely is on Patriot and the one person reacting to him in the crowd. And the rest are kind of shadowy figures that don't get much.
I also drew this like in the morning before I went to work, so I did this like 20 minutes. I was like, part of the reason why I ended up doing Patriot is because I was like, I was originally gonna do Nightwing, and I was like, I don't have time, straw hair, it's bald, who's bald Patriot? Okay, let's do it.
That's my favorite part of these critiques, when we're like, that is a valid point. If only it were not 2 a.m. Also, this whole time, I've been loving my giant red nose that I got on the beach of Toronto. I think that related to Patriot because he's bald and my nose is clearly bald at that time.
Gotcha.
Good. Yeah. That's awesome. Good job, everyone. And, if you're watching this in kind of real time and, working along with us, please submit your stuff to us and maybe we'll go over it at the start of the next issue.
Definitely.
Totally. And so I guess it's onward and upward to chapter 2, which is called Every Picture Tells a Story.
And if you're interested in buying Drawing Words for Pictures, we'll include a link so you can go buy. We should really start like an Amazon store or something and make some money off this. But yeah.
Totally. Good. Well, we won't do that. We'll just link you to the Amazon page. And yeah, check it out. Goodbye.
Thanks. Bye.